Hello friends and welcome back. Our today's topic is Thevenin's theorem. So we are discussing various theorems for circuit analysis, and this is one of the most commonly used theorem for circuit analysis. By using this theorem, you can calculate the current flowing through any branch of any linear network. Okay, first of all we will see how this theorem works. Okay, and then with the help of one example I will explain how this theorem can be used to calculate the current flowing through any branch. Okay, so friends, let us suppose we are having this circuit and our aim is to calculate the current flowing through this resistance R3. Okay, so R3 is acting as our load resistance. Now when you want to find this current using Thevenin's theorem, you have to convert this circuit into Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So it will be like this. So it consists of only two elements, one voltage source. This voltage is called as Thevenin's voltage, okay, and one resistance which is called as Thevenin's resistance, so RTH and VTH. Okay, and along with these two elements we have to connect the load resistance. Now here we have to find out the current flowing through resistance R3. So R3 is acting as your load resistance, so that load resistance we will connect in between these two terminals like this. So this will be your complete circuit. Okay, and since this is current flowing through the load, we can call this current as load current IL. So let us suppose current flowing through the load is IL. Okay, now if you want to calculate this current flowing through load resistance, it will be like this. IL is equal to, now according to Ohm's law, I is equal to what? Voltage divided by resistance. So what is the voltage available in your circuit? Thevenin's voltage. Okay, and what is the resistance? Now RTH and this R3 load resistance are in series, so we will add them. So what we are getting? VTH upon RTH plus R3. This is nothing but the load current. So by using this formula we can calculate the current flowing through the load resistance. So in this way, any critical network can be converted into a simple equivalent circuit which consists of Thevenin's voltage and Thevenin's resistance, and then with the help of this formula we can calculate the current flowing through the load. Okay, so this theorem is basically applied in three steps. First we will calculate what is the value of VTH, then in the second step we will calculate the value of RTH, and finally we will calculate the current. Okay, so we will take one example. With the help of that example you will clearly understand how we can apply Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so friends, consider this example. Again, this is a T-type network, okay, and our aim is to calculate current IL. So IL is nothing but the current flowing through this 6 ohm resistance. So by using Thevenin's theorem, you have to calculate this current. We have already solved this numerical by using nodal analysis and superposition theorem. Our answer was 468 milliampere. Now we will apply Thevenin's theorem and we will compare whether we are getting the same result or not. Okay, so your very first step will be calculation of VTH. VTH is also known as VOC. VOC means open circuit voltage. Okay, so in order to find this VOC, we have to remove this branch. Which branch? The branch through which you want to find out the current, that branch should be open circuited. So your circuit will be like this. Now you have removed this 6 ohm resistance because it was your load resistance. So now we are getting this open circuit. So we will measure the voltage between these open points, that is nothing but your open circuit voltage or Thevenin's voltage. Okay, now in order to measure this voltage, what we will do, we will apply mesh analysis over here. Okay, so for that purpose, so friends, suppose one loop current is flowing through this loop. So let us suppose that loop current is I. Okay, now when this current passes through this 10 ohm, we will get polarities like this, positive, negative, here again positive, negative. The terminal in which current is entering, that is taken as positive. Okay, so now if we apply KVL to this loop, so we will get the equation like this. So this loop consists of 4 parameters, 6 volt, 10 ohm, 8 ohm and 4 volt. So every parameter you have to write in terms of voltage because we want to write the voltage equation, KVL, voltage law. Okay, so what you are having, 6 volt, then 10 ohm, So this is resistance multiplied by current. You will get the voltage, voltage drop, resistance into current, you will get voltage drop. Then again 8 ohm, again multiply with current. So what you are getting, again voltage drop you are getting, and finally 4 volt. So it is a voltage term, so write as it is. So algebraic sum of all these terms should be equal to what? 0. Okay, now you have to put the sign. So for putting sign, you have to consider the direction of current. Now in 6 volt, current is entering from negative terminal. So here we will write minus. Now in 10 ohm and 8 ohm, current is entering from positive terminal. So we will write positive over here. And in 4 volt, again current is entering from positive terminal. So we will write 4 volt. So this equation we are getting. Now from, if you calculate this, you will get 18I is equal to 2. And from this you will get the value of loop current I. So it will be 111 milliampere. Okay. Now friends, why we have calculated this current? Because here you can see that we are having 6 volt. Okay. And out of this 6 volt, some voltage will drop across 10 ohm. And remaining voltage will be available at this point. So the voltage at this point is nothing but what? Open circuit voltage. Okay. So voltage at this point, it is nothing but what? Open circuit voltage. And what is open circuit voltage? If some voltage will drop across this 10 ohm, if we subtract that voltage from 6 volt, we will get the VOC. Means what we can write over here, VOC is equal to what? 6 volt minus voltage drop across 10 ohm. So let us suppose V10 we are writing, voltage drop across 10 ohm. Okay, now this is what? 6 minus, now what is voltage? Voltage is current multiplied by resistance. So I into R. Okay. Now what we are getting over here, 6 minus. Now your current is how much? 111 milliampere and multiplied by resistance. So what is the resistance value we are having? 10 ohm. Okay. So what we are getting, if you calculate this, you will get VOC is equal to 4.88 volt. So VOC is nothing but what? Your Thevenin's voltage. So we have got our first answer. Now next step is to calculate Thevenin's resistance. In order to calculate Thevenin's resistance, we will disable the all the energy sources. So if you are having voltage source, then it should be replaced with short circuit, and if you are having current source, then it should be replaced with open circuit. So we will replace this 4 volt and 6 volt with short circuit like this. So friends, here you can see that we have shorted both voltage sources. Okay, and now in between these two points we will measure Thevenin's resistance. Okay, so now here you can see that this 10 ohm and this 8 ohm, these two are coming in parallel. So your equivalent circuit will be like this. So friends, here this 10 ohm and 8 ohm are in parallel. So your equivalent resistance will be 10 ohm parallel to 8 ohm. So this will be like this. So RTH becomes, so you will get 4.44 ohm. So now you have got the open circuit voltage and you have got the Thevenin's resistance. Now last step is to calculate load current. So friends, for this purpose we will draw the equivalent circuit, Thevenin's equivalent circuit like this. So friends, here your Thevenin's voltage we have already calculated 4.88 volt. Okay, what was your Thevenin's resistance? That also we have calculated, 4.44 ohm. Okay, and what is your load resistance? It is 6 ohm. Okay, and we have to calculate this current, current flowing through 6 ohm, which we are calling as load current. Okay, now according to our formula, we have already written this formula in the beginning. What is IL? Current is equal to voltage upon the resistance. So what is the voltage we are having? VTH. And what is the resistance we are having? RTH and RL, because Thevenin's, this resistance and this load resistance, these are in series. So put these values, we will get this. If we calculate this, we will get 0.467 ampere. So in milliampere it will be 467 milliampere. So this is the current we are getting by applying Thevenin's theorem. Now we will compare this result with result of nodal analysis and superposition theorem. So at that time we have got the answer as, so friends, by superposition theorem we have got the current as 467 milliampere. So in Thevenin's theorem also we are getting the same answer. Now again we will look at the answer of nodal analysis. So friends, during nodal analysis also we have got 468 milliampere. So almost same answer we are getting. In nodal analysis we are getting 468 milliampere, and in superposition theorem and Thevenin's theorem we are getting 467 milliampere, means almost same answer we are getting. So friends, in this way, by using this theorem, we can calculate the current flowing through any branch of the network. So friends, I have already performed one practical on this Thevenin's theorem. The link is available in the description. So thank you very much for watching this. If you really like this, please press the like button and do not forget to subscribe my channel. So thank you very much. Have a nice day.